Hey folks, it's Sean from delistedgames.com back again with another quick look at an Xbox 360 trial version of a game that's been delisted, Tony Hawk's Pro Skater HD. The very first thing I need to do is get in here and turn the music down, or this will never make it online. This was released on the Xbox 360, PlayStation 3, and Steam in July, August, and September of 2012 from Robomoto and Activision, of course, who at the time still had the, save it. There's real licensed music in this game. One of the reasons, probably the major reason, that it was delisted in the first place. Activision announced on the game's Steam page that Tony Hawk's Pro Skater HD would be retired from the store on Monday, July 17th, 2017. Oh, hold on, Tony. The game was put on a final sale in the week leading up to it, and it was delisted the same day on PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360. Yep. How do you transfer? Just push forward? Just push forward in this version. Okay, that wall ride's not gonna work. Come on. I am one of those old guys that feels Tony Hawk just doesn't feel right unless it's on a PlayStation controller. Even back in the day, the Dreamcast version looked real good, but just didn't feel right. So imagine that a pop punk or a metal song is playing right now, and you'll get the idea of what the soundtrack was like. Come on, I'm trying to spell a word here. Nope, gonna miss that one again. Sorry about the cat interference in the background. They're awake from a nap and fighting. Nope, I really need the S. Ah. Okay, now that I'm stationary. You know, I was never the best at Tony Hawk, but I did love playing it. Okay, it's fading out because my time with the demo is over. Let's try and unlock the full game. Nope, no longer available. And you can forget about a relisting on this one, as Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 1 and 2 remake are, at this point in 2020, on their way out. Yeah, we know how to play. Feel free to pause if you'd like to brush up on how to play Tony Hawk. Well, better turn that down. Controls, there we go. Can't look at the gap list, but we can run the credits. While I look at a little bit more about this, no confirmation was given about the delisting, but it was likely due to a combination of the game's mediocre reception and expired licensing. I wrote this a while ago. I would say it's almost certainly because of the music licensing and the licensing around Tony Hawk. Activision also delisted Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 5. If I can get over here and type Tony into our search bar. Yeah, and Pro Skater 5 wasn't until 2018. Couldn't remember if they delisted them both around the same time. It does look like Steam codes are still available from Amazon, so you could get a Steam code for this game from Amazon for $9.99 if you were particularly fond of this version. Although I don't think it was quite as well received. Any DLC? Tony Hawk did some QA on this. I wonder if he got paid for that, on top of licensing his face. Let's see. Let me see if I can get over to some reviews here. I didn't buy this when it was released, and I didn't pay too much attention to it because I could just go back and play the original version myself. Let's see. But even with a limited breadth of content, Tony Hawk HD manages to dish out more nostalgic fun for $15 than our last few retail purchases combined. That's the highest score. The official PlayStation magazine Benelux said, believe it or not, but Tony Hawk used to be hip. PSM3 Magazine UK, looks new and feels old. A game good in its own time, but not in ours. Ouch. Now it's starting to look as old and creaky as some of its skaters. Yikes, that's uncalled for. I believe, yeah, limited breadth of content. I can't remember if they released a lot of stuff through DLC if you didn't even get the full original game. I know there were some of the licensed songs were missing from this version, which the majority of them are being added into the new Tony Hawk 1 and 2 remake, which almost certainly guarantees that it will be delisted again in about 5 to 7 years if licensing terms hold up like they did in the Xbox 360 generation. So some very long credits. I should have figured that was going to happen. There's no way to speed that up, but I usually let the credits play in these videos, even though it's just the trial version of the game. Let's see what else some people said here. Give me just a minute. Okay, here we go. Part of the Tony Hawk's Pro Skater series, Pro Skater HD is a remake of the series' earliest entries, Tony Hawk 1 and 2. Instead of porting the original games, Robomoto built a new engine, built on Unreal Engine 3, that recreates the physics and general gameplay of the original. Many gameplay elements added in later games, such as dismounting from the skateboard, were not included to keep the aesthetic. Although some game modes from later games were added. The game later received a paid DLC pack on December 4th, 2012, dubbed the Revert Pack. That's what it was. It adds 3 levels from Tony Hawk 3, 4 additional skaters, 1 new music track. The update accompanying this DLC pack also added the Revert Trick mechanic from Tony Hawk 3, hence the pack's name. See anything about the reception here. Game features a licensed soundtrack with half of the songs being from Tony Hawk 1 and 2 and the other half being new songs that have never been used in a Tony Hawk game. It should be noted that of the returning songs, only one is from the first Tony Hawk, the remainder being from Tony Hawk 2. So not only did they have the licensed music, but in that Revert pack, they added, oh gosh, where did it go? Guest character, 4 additional skaters, including guest characters from the band Metallica, and a Metallica song. So that's a good way to get your game delisted down the line. Put Metallica in it. Let's see. Tony Hawk's Pro Skater HD has received mixed reviews upon release. Currently holds aggregate 67%. IGN gave the game a score of 8 out of 10, praising its purest gameplay whilst lamenting the lack of certain modes such as park creator and split-screen multiplayer. Reviewer from Game Trailers gave the game a score of 7.4 and stated it isn't flawless, but at least it gets off on the right foot. Games Radar felt that old-school fans of the franchise will be disappointed with what the game lacks, and the gamers who've never laid eyes on a PS1 will find the mechanics and level design sparse. Destructoid gave the game 4.5 out of 10, stating that the execution isn't handled as well as the original titles, as well as some of the design choices the developers made. G4TV gave the game a 4.5 out of 5, praised the console version's online multiplayer and soundtrack. Official Xbox Magazine gave it an 8 out of 10. They praised the game's new Big Head mode. I feel like that part of Wikipedia could use a little bit of an edit. Wow, these credits are still going. Unless they started over. I always hate when a game does that, when I'm not looking. Nope, we're just now down to the music. Yeah, I think some of this response is why I, or some of the reception from this version is why I never bought it. Part of the reason that I never bought it. And then seeing a revert pack, I actually thought this whole time that you couldn't do the revert unless you bought the revert DLC. But it was just in name. There we go. Superman's in there. All of these, each one of these is quality reason to be delisted. It's very unfortunate. It's usually a soundtrack reason, like a music licensing or content licensing, something featured in a game. It's always a bad idea anymore. It's pretty sad. Let me just lament delistings while these credits roll. Oh, they kept the music credits for the last, for the end, because they knew that's what everybody would want to see. Since there's not a sound test in it. Okay, yeah, we're good. All right, well, I think that's about it that we can get to here. Any chance we can see some leaderboards? There we go. Wow. All right, well, thanks for watching this quick look at Tony Hawk's Pro Skater HD on the Xbox 360. Take a look at delistedgames.com for more on this and over 1,000 delisted games now, and so many more to be added. Check out the rest of the YouTube channel for more hands-on videos, what remains after a game gets shut down, featured soundtracks from games that you can't find anywhere else, really. Especially not officially. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.